Hello everyone and welcome back. Last week zipped by is quite fast, but let's take a look at the news. About 7 months ago, Sweets bumped Christian Fraser up to legend for his decade of Kendama play and also teased a new legend mod for him. It's got a slightly larger and more defined shape and interesting balance bevel, Mabel Kensaki Beach Wench Mabel Sarado, a Walnut Cherry Wench Beach Kama, and also comes coated with Kush Clear. Fast forward back to last Friday, the first batch of the decade mod was put up for sale and it sold out so quick. Since this is called batch 1, it's gonna be safe to assume that there'll be more coming in the future. Sit tight, keep a close eye on the social media sites to know when the next drop is coming. Continuing on the Craft Fauna series, Kendama USA released yet another colorway for it called Toucan. It's got a 5 split colorway, making it easier to track, and as usual, comes in either the shift or slim variants. Japanese custom painter Zawadama put up 3 new custom paints online. The cans, I believe, are supplied by Engi Kendama, and the 3 designs are Blue Rose, Leopard, and GB. I'm not too sure if he ships worldwide. Do send him a DM on Instagram or email if you'd like to find out more. Moving on to events, Nashville, Tennessee played host to its own Sakura Classic over the weekend. 4 categories contested in the beginner speed ladder: 3rd place Mark Magyar, 2nd place Connor, and 1st place Rose Booth. In the intermediate speed ladder, 3rd place Danny Rankin, 2nd place Dalton Hodge, and 1st place Michael Aubrey. In the advanced speed ladder, Cody Booth in 3rd place, Caleb West in 2nd, and grabbing 1st place, Nick Dodenhoff. And finally, in the open division, 3rd place Nick Dodenhoff, and 2nd place Cody Booth again. And finally, the 1st place is won by Saul's Liam Router. The San Francisco edition of the Sakura Classic took place just hours ago, and I'm happy to report the results. 2 divisions contested and an open. 3rd place Zach Gallagher lost to Ben Harold in the semis, landing him in the loser's bracket to face off against 2nd place Bonzatron, who was eliminated in round 4 by Joshua Grove. Bonds clawed his way through the loser's bracket, taking the win there against Nick Stodd, and then besting Zach to land himself in the finals against Ben Harold. But Ben proved to be in the better shape as he takes the win for Grain Theory. Completing the GT sweep, Stodd also bagged 1st place in freestyle, and that wasn't the only thing Nick had to smile about, and that's because Grain Theory just announced a new pro mod for him. Brand new can shape designed by Stodd, 16.5cm tall, 23mm bevel, Portland inspired designs. It's even got an outline of the state of Portland on the logo, and what I believe is a first for GT, a painted coated Tama on its pro mod. Congrats to Stodd and to all the winners. And that's a wrap. Comment below if I missed anything. Subscribe if you haven't. Hit on the bell icon to keep up to date. The name's Adrian, and until next time, stay lit and Dama on. Bye.